Ah, yes, the infamous System32 virus that exists on all Windows PCs. Well, not really, obviously. We've all heard the joke that System32 is a virus to delete it, but it's actually a critical Windows directory. But what would happen if you did delete System32? Obviously, Windows would no longer be able to boot, but would you be able to recover it somehow? How much damage would it really do, even while you're deleting it and still running Windows? What would happen? Well, that's what we're gonna do in this video. We're gonna do a real-life demonstration of what happens if you were to delete System32 on your computer. And quickly, before we do that, just so you guys have some context, why don't we go over what exactly System32 is and why it's important? Because there's a lot of Windows directories, so what's the big deal about this one? Like I mentioned before, System32 has a ton of critical files that are essential not only for Windows itself, but also third-party programs that are running on Windows. So this includes shared libraries like dynamic link libraries or DLLs. It has driver folders like for hardware and stuff that makes hardware work, and even some built-in core Windows programs, things like the Task Manager or Notepad, all exist in the System32 folder. And there's actually another similar folder in the Windows directory called SysWOW64, and the WOW64 stands for Windows 32-bit on Windows 64-bit, and basically this actually holds a bunch of 32-bit libraries and stuff, whereas the System32 has the 64-bit libraries. So yes, System32 has the 64-bit stuff, and SysWOW64 has the 32-bit stuff. It doesn't really make sense. It's basically just for backwards compatibility from developers who didn't really plan ahead. But needless to say, the stuff in the System32 folder is used by just about everything, so deleting it would be pretty much catastrophic for the Windows installation. Now, normally, you cannot delete the System32 folder. It's protected by permissions, so even if you tried to do it, it would say permission denied. So it's basically impossible to do this accidentally, and even if you were trying to, unless you knew how to get around these things, you wouldn't have any worries about deleting System32 by mistake. But in this case, we really do want to delete System32. So what I'm going to do is kind of mess around with the permissions and give myself access so I can actually delete it. Now, I'm not going to show how to go through and do all that because it's a little bit complicated, and I don't want you guys knowing how to go and prank your friends by ruining their computer. But needless to say, we'll kind of jump right into it. And I am doing this on a virtual machine, so I'm not going to destroy a regular computer installation. So at this point, we're now inside Windows, and I do actually have the permissions to delete pretty much all of the files. And there are still some weird safeguards in place. For example, I might not be able to delete everything that's in use, and seeing as it's a system directory, there's quite a few of things in use, but there's still plenty of stuff that's critical that I can delete. So we're pretty much gonna have some fun here and delete everything I can. If I try to delete everything in bulk, it kind of blocks me and just doesn't delete anything. So I'm gonna try and delete large segments at once, and then you can see if I delete folders and DLLs, I get the occasional error message, but a lot of times it will let me do it, and they do get added to the recycle bin. And if you check in there, you can see quite a bit of things are getting deleted. So really, I'm pretty much just highlighting as much as I can in a large swath and deleting it. It seems to let me delete most of the DLLs and stuff, but the folders, it won't let me delete anything in it because if there's one thing in there, it's kind of weird. Probably a lot of extra permissions and safeguards are in this folder specifically, but it seems like I'm still able to delete a pretty good chunk, and I guarantee this is gonna break things. So right now I've already deleted a ton of stuff and the system is already acting pretty weird. So you can see I can't really use the start menu. I try to click on things, it doesn't do anything. I open up menus and it's just blank or it crashes. Stuff really isn't loading, random error messages all over the place, and even when I try to go reboot by clicking the start menu, the power button, nothing appears. So even without rebooting, the system is already basically broken. You can't launch the task manager. Everything's destroyed at this point. But Windows is at least still running. So what I'm gonna do is manually reboot the virtual machine and see what happens afterwards. So I'll just reboot it now and we can wait for it to load. And you can pretty much see it instantly tries to go into automatic repair. It knows right away that something's wrong and that Windows failed to boot. And it says diagnosing your computer. And it did so much damage. Look, right now it says automatic repair could not repair your PC. So we probably at this point would have to do a complete new reinstall of Windows to get this computer working again, if it was a real computer. Though we can click through to advanced options and just kind of see what's there. So we can click on reset this PC and see what happens, remove everything, and even that didn't work. It says there was a problem resetting your PC. So probably a lot of the recovery stuff is gone. And we can even click through some of the other options in this troubleshooting Windows environment, and nothing really here is going to solve it. So really this Windows installation is destroyed. The computer itself obviously is not. You could still reinstall Windows on it, but it's really gonna be a pain. So clearly through that demonstration, we can see that it was no surprise what happens when you delete System32. The Windows installation is ruined until you completely reinstall Windows, and you really can't do anything with it. Even with the built-in recovery features, it won't be able to fix it. So now going forward into the future, if you were ever tempted in the slightest to delete System32 just to see what happens, now you don't have to. And you can know that, look, it's probably not even worth it to do it to friends, because you probably won't even be able to fix it yourself. And they will be kind of mad if they have to take it to a computer shop to reinstall Windows and back up all their data. Not really worth it. But anyway, hopefully this video was kind of fun. Wasn't too long, I don't think. So let me know what you think down in the comment section. Have you ever accidentally deleted System32? I'd love to hear about it. And also, if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make a couple new videos every week, so it should be worth it. So thanks again, guys, for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.